Hachette Audio presents an RDA Press audio production of Start Your Own Corporation by Garrett Sutton, Esquire. Read by Garrett Sutton.
Acknowledgements. This book is dedicated to my wonderful wife, Jenny, and our terrific kids, Teddy, Emily, and Sarah. Thank you for your understanding as this book was being written. I would also like to acknowledge the assistance of Robert Kiyosaki and Mona Gambetta in the revision and updating of this book. Thank you.
Foreword by Robert Kiyosaki, read by Steve Stratton. When I was 10 years old and in the fifth grade, I began to read about the great explorers, such as Columbus, Magellan, Cortez, Da Gama, Cook. I dreamed of someday traveling the world in a wooden ship in search of treasures in unexplored lands. I read every book I could about their lives and adventures. In the fifth grade, I often had the highest scores on the tests and quizzes about the great explorers. You read about the explorers who were successful, said Rich Dad. What about the explorers who failed? Rich Dad was helping me prepare for my final exam in the fifth grade.
The ones who failed, I asked.
Yes, the ones who fail, said Rich Dad. In school, they teach you about the successful explorers or the famous explorers. There were many more explorers who were not successful and not famous, whom we have never heard about, nor will we ever hear about them.
Why is studying about explorers who failed so important, I ask?
Because you need to know how the owners and the investors in those failed voyages protected themselves against the repercussions from such failures, said Rich Dad.
Repercussions? I asked. What kind of repercussions?
Such things as the loss of life, said Rich Dad. The owners and investors wanted to protect themselves and their fortunes from the families of the explorer and his crew in the event there was a loss of life on the voyage.
You mean the men on the ship risked and sometimes lost their lives, and all the owners and investors on land wanted to do was protect themselves from losing money? That's one of the repercussions you're talking about?
Rich Dad nodded his head. He then began to tell me about the Dutch East India Company and the British East India Company, two of the more powerful and famous corporations behind some of those explorers. Some of these corporations even had their own navy and army to control access to their nation's overseas wealth. He told me how these corporations, in many ways, took over whole countries, such as New Zealand, Hawaii, Australia, Malaysia, Indonesia, South Africa, and other parts of the world. One of those countries was one day to become the United States of America. Rich Dad pointed out to me that the flag of the United States was originally the flag of the British East India Company, reportedly modified by Betsy Ross. While England may have lost control over its colonies, the British East India Company simply changed its name, a simple DBA, and kept on trading. The more Rich Dad told me about the corporations behind these great explorers and how they shaped world history, the more interested I became in global business and doing business through a corporation. When I was 16, I began applying for a congressional appointment to the U.S. Merchant Marine Academy, the federal military school that trains young men to sail ships of the Merchant Marine. King's Point, which the school is also known as, continues to train young people to replace the great seafaring explorers. Only two students from Hawaii are admitted to this little-known federal academy each year, so I felt fortunate to be accepted after passing rigorous exams and interviews. At age 18, I began sailing as a student on board ships, carrying cargo along the same trade routes established by Ferdinand Magellan and Captain James Cook. I quickly realized that although the early explorers are gone, some of those corporations Rich Dad talked about still exist today, and the United States government funds the education of these corporations' leaders. I began to understand why Rich Dad told me years ago, don't just study the explorer and his ships. Study the power of the corporations behind the explorer and his ships. The 747 replaces cargo ships. Today, I travel by 747 rather than by cargo ship. Although my mode of transportation has changed, I've heeded Rich Dad's advice and learned my lessons well. Today, I travel as a representative of several corporations. The difference is that I control those corporations rather than simply work for them. As I stated in Rich Dad, Poor Dad, my poor dad thought it was a good idea to be a good employee and climb the corporate ladder. While my rich dad said, don't climb the corporate ladder, why not own the corporate ladder? Rich Dad also said,
The problem with climbing the corporate ladder is that when you look up, you see somebody's big fat butt above you. On a more serious note, he said, the two main reasons you need to start your own corporation are for protection against lawsuits and against excessive taxes. Yet there are many other reasons and other strategies. The point is, if you're serious about being rich and keeping your wealth, understanding corporations and other legal structures is an important part of your ongoing financial education. Introducing Garrett Sutton. I'm pleased to introduce Garrett Sutton to you. Often in my classes, students ask me questions about corporations and legal structures. My standard reply is, I did not go to law school and I'm not an attorney, so I do not give advice on that subject. I suggest you do as I do. Find a good attorney and use him or her as your advisor on this very important subject. I am pleased to announce to you my advisor in these matters, Garrett Sutton. He's a pleasure to work with, and he is more than a great advisor, he's a great teacher. As Rich Dad said to me years ago, if you are serious about being rich and keeping your wealth, understanding corporations and other legal structures is an important part of your ongoing financial education.
Introduction. Congratulations, you are about to undertake a powerful and enlightening journey. By reading this book, you will learn quickly and easily the legal secrets and strategies that the rich have used to run their businesses, hold their real estate, and protect their assets. In short order, you will clearly understand exactly how certain entities, corporations, limited liability companies, and limited partnerships, can not only save you thousands and thousands of dollars in taxes, but can also save your house and savings and family assets from the attacks of creditors. And because real estate is an important component of your wealth strategy, we've included information on using good entities to protect your real estate holdings from attack. These are the same lessons that Robert Kiyosaki's Rich Dad taught him. Own nothing and control everything. Use the techniques of the rich to improve your financial standing and protect your family. And above all, work smarter instead of harder. This is the fifth edition of this book, which has just been updated for the new tax law. In discussions with readers, there is a great deal of interest in knowing what to do once your entity is formed. To that end, a companion book to this one is available and entitled Run Your Own Corporation. As well, we have updated Start Your Own Corporation to include new strategies for maximum results. As such, by the time you finish this book, you will have the legal savvy of an experienced entrepreneur and the knowledge necessary to immediately implement your own custom legal strategy. But first, we must mention an interesting phenomena encountered over the last 17 years this book has been in print. Readers with new knowledge will present the strategies herein to their local attorney and accountant. And in some limited cases, those professionals won't be up to speed on these useful strategies. Instead of revealing their knowledge gap, they will reflexively claim that this information is not accurate. We want you to always work with excellent professionals who will craft the best structures for your situation. But a professional who says, it can't be done here, or asset protection will get you in trouble, may not be the best person for you. The rich have used these very same strategies for generations to protect their wealth. It has been done here, there, and everywhere. You can do it too, with the right professional. All right, let's begin. Chapter 1, Your Entity Menu. Welcome to the world of asset protection and entity formation. As you gain knowledge of the strategies and advantages, and you will in this book, you will come to appreciate your six main menu choices: C Corporation, S Corporation, Limited Liability Company, or LLC, Limited Partnership, or LP, General Partnership, and Sole Proprietorship. As legal business systems and traditions have developed over the last 500 years, several structures for running a business have evolved. Each structure or entity has its own benefits and drawbacks, which we will explore. First off, what does the word entity mean? It refers to an organization, be it a business or governmental unit, which has a legal identity separate from its members. It is derived from the Latin word ens, meaning an existing or real thing. So an entity is a real thing, distinguishable and apart from its owners. Two of the six choices aren't really real things, which, as you will learn, is not a good thing. As a frame of reference for making your entity selection, it is important for you to clarify your strategy in this planning. The purpose of this chapter is for you to clearly understand and choose the best entity for your unique and specific purpose. To that end, the following checklist should be considered. 1. Protection of family assets and investments. 2. Management control. 3. Avoiding family disputes. 4. Flexibility of decision making. 5. Succession of children and other family members to management. 6. The nature of the business to be operated. 7. The nature of the asset to be held. 8. The number of owners involved. 9. Estate planning and gifting of assets. 10. Who may legally obligate the business? 11. The effect upon an owner's death or departure. 12. The need for startup funding and raising of capital. 13. Taxation. 14. Privacy of ownership. And 15. Consolidation of assets and investments. These and other issues will become apparent as we review your choices. And please note, your decision does not have to be made alone. It is recommended that these issues be discussed with your attorney, accountant, or other professional advisor. An individual well-versed in these areas will provide excellent insight into which entity is right for you. By listening to this book, you will be better able to work with your professional advisors. They won't have to spend time explaining all of the tax issues and limitations of liability strategies to you. By listening to this book, you will have a leg up. When you meet with your advisors, you won't be stepping up to the plate for the first time. Instead, you'll be at second base, ready to score. And fear not, our first sports analogy is also our last one. It is important to know that in entity selection, one size does not fit all. If your attorney or accountant suggests only one entity, a general partnership, for example, for each and every business venture you have him or her review, you will want to question why they believe one entity fits all situations. Or you may want to seek out a new professional advisor. We will discuss which entities work well in various business and asset holding scenarios. But before doing so, we must point out which entities do not work well in any situation. For as important as knowing which entity to use for running your business, protecting your assets, and limiting your liability, is knowing which entity not to use. Bad entities, sole proprietorships, and general partnerships. In my legal practice, I represent various businesses, from small and basic to large and complicated. I enjoy helping entrepreneurs and business owners make money, provide for their families and employees, and secure a stable future. I cannot do my job if a client insists on using a bad entity. Sole proprietorships and general partnerships provide no asset protection. Remember the Latin word ens? It means an existing or real thing. These bad entities are not separate legal things. You haven't registered them with your state. Instead, they are just you, doing business without any protection. One lawsuit against your business and your house, savings, and personal assets can all be lost. Our first case is illustrative. Case number one, Johnny. Johnny was a plumber. He had been at it for 5 years and was starting to succeed. His customers were satisfied with his work, and the word of mouth for Johnny's Ace Plumbing was good. While Johnny was a good plumber, he felt intimidated by legal matters. Lawyers and accountants were supposed to be smart, so the work they did must be difficult. When Johnny was a young boy, his father had been unfairly treated by a lawyer. He remembered it to this day and wanted nothing to do with them. So instead of consulting with a
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.